Reconheçamos e confessemos humildemente os nossos pecados. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I suppose that we are in your church. All the angels and saints, endue my brothers and sisters to pray for you to the Lord our God. Deus Todo-Poderoso, tendo compaixão de nós, perdoa os nossos pecados e nos conduz à vida eterna.
Amém.
servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Father St. Clark, please be seated. The first reading will be done by Jeanette Maldonado, reading from the Old Testament.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The whole Israelite community grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The Israelites said to them, "Would that we had died at the Lord's hands in the land of Egypt, as we sat by our flesh pots and ate our fill of bread, that you had to lead us into this desert to make the whole community die of famine." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I will now rain down bread from heaven for you. Each day the people are to go out and gather their daily portion. Thus I will test them to see whether they follow my instructions or not. I have heard the grumbling of the Israelites. Tell them, in the evening twilight you shall eat flesh, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread, so that you may know that I, the Lord, am your God." In the evening, quail came up and covered the camp. In the morning, a dew lay out about the camp. And when the dew evaporated, then on the surface of the desert were fine flakes like hoarfrost on the ground. On seeing it, the Israelites asked one another, "What is this?" For they did not know what it was. But Moses told them, "This is the bread that the Lord has given to you to eat." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Brothers and sisters, I declare and testify in the Lord that we must no longer live as Gentiles do, in the futility of their minds. That is not how you learn Christ, assuming that you have heard of him and were taught of him, as truth is in Jesus, that you should put away the old self of your former way of life, corrupted through deceitful desires, and be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and put on the new self created in God's ways, in the righteousness and holiness of the truth. For the Lord.
Please stand. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" Jesus answered them and said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him the Father God has set his seal." So they said to him, "What can we do to accomplish the works of God?" Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent." So they said to him, "What sign can you do that we may see and believe in you? When can you do? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written. He gave them bread from the heaven to eat." So Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." So they said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia,
like in the old days, over 2,000 years ago, now we are still looking for Jesus. Not, hopefully not for food that may help our bodies, but for the real food, the bread of life, which is the Eucharistic bread that we celebrate at each Eucharistic celebration. And the Lord realized that those people following him, because they wanted to eat, they had a free meal the day before, and they wanted more, and the Lord told them off. Who doesn't like a free meal? I do. Friday night, the Cabral, Mr. and Mrs. Cabral offered me a nice dinner. It was nice. Hopefully they'll do it again. We all need, we all like, we all enjoy a free meal, whether it's a soup from the Terra, or a meal paid by the Cabral, or anyone else.
It's important to, we need to eat, but we also need, for those of you, those of us with faith, we know we need the bread of life that endures forever, that it will help us achieve and gain the trophy. The only trophy that matters for her is eternal life. And thank God. Thank you also for bringing God into this convention. And nowadays we live in a world where even on TV we see a news media and DJs making fun of those who have faith, making statements in public, like I saw not long ago on RTP. I don't believe in God. I'm not a believer. Well, that's your problem. Keep it for yourself. Don't spread the word. Don't do anything to contagiate other people, those who believe in God. But even those who do not believe in God, God believes in you. Even those who do not love God, God loves you because He loves everyone. But thank you to the committee of this convention to bring God into this convention. And too bad we don't have as many young people as you. We had at the theater yesterday. And it's not a good sign that the older ones, we have to do something to recruit more younger people to attend Mass, to attend the sacraments. Otherwise, we will be left and reduced to a smaller and smaller group. And it is our job as disciples to preach, not just my job. Everyone who has been baptized as a disciple and has the obligation to preach through words and through deeds. And you and I will be judged by whether we did it or not. Yes, indeed. So let's work hard enough to change this mentality of some public announcers on TV claiming that I don't believe in God, I'm not a believer. Shame on them. And so we give thanks to God for this group, for this convention, because so far as I remember, we've always had a convention mass, and it's important to have God present at this convention. In fact, He should be our guest of honor at the convention every year. And we are not competing for trophies like yesterday, the different groups performed to compete for it, and with reason, and it was nice. We all compete for one. Here there's only one prize, number one, which is life eternal, and we have to work for it. As they say in Spanish, si se puede. It's up to us to earn it. But even though it was nice to have competition and reward those who did wonderfully, in my opinion, they all did great. And I was also very touched and moved to see Father YC2 of San Jose, to see in the middle of the stage, the heart of the Portuguese community, the Atayut style with the picture of my parish Fibus Church, exactly the same one that you found or you find when you go to petition downtown. And yes, we are the church, not Five Wounds, not St. Clair's, not St. Joseph's. We, the people, are the church, the living church that needs to do something through our words and our deeds. But people are embarrassed to talk about the Lord. People are ashamed to claim that, yes, I'm Catholic, I'm a believer. People are embarrassed to talk to one another about the Lord, about the scriptures. Do you read the Bible? Do you pray? Do you attend Mass? No, I don't. My father goes, my mother, my grandma. It's for the young people here, please put that in your hands. It's a big mistake, and it's our fault. Priest's fault and the older one's fault. Yes, we cannot claim it, the celebration of the sacrament, especially this one, the Eucharist, to older people. So I thank those of you, the young people are here, not too many, not as many as I wish, but yes, it is a beginning. It is a good sign, and it shows that your families care about you, that your families have given you the right formation and the right faith. Because faith is not something you buy at a store. Faith is our attitude towards the Lord's teachings. We hear the teachings, we hear the Word of God, and we accept, and that's called faith. It is not enough to accept. We need to practice, to live it every single day of our lives as a family. Each family here is a domestic church. Together, we are also a church, the living church of Luz American Financial. And therefore, once again, it is great that you once again decided to bring God into this convention. And the bread of life, when the Lord talks about eating those who will eat his flesh and drink his blood, of course he talks not literally, but meaning the real food, the bread, the host that once consecrated becomes the body of Christ, and the wine that becomes the blood of Christ. Of course, we cannot live without the other food, sweet bread, dinner rolls, popsicles, and other meals. We need that for our bodies, but it's just as important, if not more important, to really feed our souls, to feed our spirits and our hearts with the bread of life, with the Holy Communion, both, not just through communion, but also the Word of God, which was proclaimed from the Old Testament, from the New Testament, in the Gospel. God is present at this convention through his body and blood. He is also present through the word that has been proclaimed. God is also present in each one of us. Each one of us should have the face of Christ and should represent to one and everyone else that face of Christ. A Christ who loves us all. A Christ who accepts us as we are, with weaknesses, with virtues, with qualities. We cannot afford to reject those. No, I don't want, like the other day someone told someone else, and I was told that for a lunch coming up at my parish, someone told her, I do not want to sit by so-and-so. Give me a break. I don't want to sit. Jesus Christ did precisely the opposite. He lived with the sinners, with Mary Magdalene, and other sinners. And even though in Portuguese we say, this does not apply to the Lord. Because the Lord, if we apply that principle to the Lord Jesus, we would call him the most horrible names. Because he ate with sinners. He ate with prostitutes. He ate with thieves, like Matthew. He even chose some of the sinners to follow him and to be the greatest apostles. Matthew was a thief, and he's a great apostle. St. Paul was a persecutor of the Christians, and he's one of the greatest to me. And St. Peter denied them three times, and yet he was given the keys of the church on earth. And so the bottom line is, sometimes it takes us to fall, to sin, to realize, oh my God, I fell and failed. And then with God's grace, we recover, and we then become the best disciples, because we've gone through hell, we've gone through weaknesses, we've been there, and then we came back to life. To me, the saints, all the saints have a past, believe me, except the Virgin Mary. All the saints have a past, and we, all the sinners, have a future. We have a chance, if you have not made that commitment, to be a true disciple at your house, at work, in the society, in the world, then it's never too late. Start now, because as I said earlier, and even if those who do not believe in God, God believes in them. Even those who say, I do not love God, God loves them all. And so this bread of life that most of us hopefully will receive at communion will be taken and accepted as a way of saying, yes, I have faith in you. Thank you for the gift of your Son who redeemed us. Thank you for the sacrament of the Eucharist that feeds our souls, and then what matters that after that we live day after day fulfilling God's will, because that's the purpose of the bread of life that the Lord left us. He told the disciples, I will be with you always until the end of ages. And that's the way that he left behind his body and blood for us to always be near him and with him. And as a bishop in Brazil the other day wrote on Facebook, we should not be afraid of dying, we should be afraid of dying without Christ. When a good way to die with Christ in our hearts is to receive the sacraments, especially the one we will soon consecrate. To die with Christ is to be saved. To die without him in our hearts is to go downstairs to be condemned. It's up to us, it's our choice. Lord respects our freedom to faith, to have faith or not, and many people don't, and many people have reasons. They've gone through a lot. How could God allow this? How could he do this to me, to my family? And many people stop praying. Many people stop going to church because of that. That's bad. It is never God's fault that someone died, that someone got sick or got cancer. No. or have an accident, he does not. He has more things to do than pulling strings out. Today I'm going to call John to myself, call Mary to Josephine. No, with that one we have to die. And a lot of times we blame the Lord and say, well, it was God's wish. No, it was not. God wishes nothing but one thing, that we love him and we love each other and one another. That's all he wants. Things happen in life, wars like today, the world we live in, with so much war, so much division, so much tragedy because of us, because there's not enough love in this world. And yet we hear many times, so many people dying hungry for food. Yes, but you know what? There's a lot more people dying for lack of love, lack of forgiveness, lack of justice. And we are called to be instruments of love in our life to one another. Charity begins at home. We must put that in our heads. We have to be instruments of love, of forgiveness, acceptance, and justice. And so I hope from all these different thoughts that I've shared with you, some will fall in good soil and some will produce fruit, hopefully the fruit that we must be, instruments of peace and love in the world. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand for the praise of the faithful, which will be read by Danette Maldonado. At the tables of the Word and the Eucharist, the Lord nourishes us on our pilgrim way. With gratitude for his goodness, let us make our intercession together.
For the Church of this diocese, brought into unity by celebrating Christ's sacrifice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For leaders who seek to follow ways of reconciliation, peace, and justice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For men and women being prepared for reception into our Eucharist family, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For deeper reverence and devotion to the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the dead who rest in Christ's care, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Senhor nosso Deus, que o povo de Israel deste o maná, e na plenitude dos tempos enviaste o vosso Filho, que nos dá o verdadeiro pão do céu, saciai a fome e a sede que temos de vós, por Jesus Cristo, nosso Senhor. Podem sentar-se, please be seated. mãos para que o meu e vosso sacrifício seja aceito por Deus Pai Todo-Poderoso. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Senhor esteja convosco. Lift up your hearts. Demos graças ao Senhor nosso Deus. It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. Pelo seu mistério pascal, Ele realizou a obra admirável de nos chamar do pecado e da morte à glória da geração escolhida, sacerdócio real, nação santa, povo resgatado, a fim de que libertes do poder das trevas para a claridade da vossa luz, anunciemos por toda a parte as vossas maravilhas. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Reunidos na vossa presença, em comunhão com toda a Igreja, ao celebrarmos o primeiro dia da semana em que nosso Senhor Jesus Cristo ressuscitou dos mortos, humildemente vos suplicamos, santificai os dons, derramando sobre eles o vosso Espírito, de modo que se convertam para nós no corpo e sangue de nosso Senhor Jesus Cristo. Na hora em que ele se entregava para voluntariamente sofrer a morte, tomou o pão e, dando graças, partiu e deu aos seus discípulos, dizendo: Tomai todos e comei, isto é o meu corpo que será entregue por vós. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mistério da fé. E vos damos graças porque nos admitiste à vossa presença para vos servir nestes santos mistérios. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lembrai-vos da vossa Igreja dispersa por toda a terra e tornai-a perfeita na caridade, em comunhão com o Papa Francisco, nosso Bispo, aos queridos, aqueles que estão ao serviço do vosso povo. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and always that in your mercy welcome them into the light of your face. Tenha misericórdia de nós, Senhor, e dá-nos a graça de participar da vida eterna com a Virgem Maria, Mãe de Deus, São José, seu esposo, os bem-aventurados apóstolos e todos os santos, que desde o princípio do mundo viveram na vossa amizade, para cantarmos vossos louvores por Jesus Cristo, vosso Filho. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Spanish or French, is to live it. How dare we ask God to forgive us if we do not forgive so-and-so and so-and-so? Shame on us. Let's pray it now and live it right after Mass. Pai nosso, que estás no céu, santificado seja o vosso nome. Venha a nós o vosso reino, seja feita a vossa vontade, assim na terra como no céu. O pão nosso cada dia nos dai hoje, perdoai-nos as nossas ofensas, assim como nós perdoamos a quem está ofendido. E não nos deixeis cair em tentação, mas livrai-nos do mal. Deliver-te, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in all days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Senhor Jesus Cristo, que disseste ao vosso apóstolo, deixe-nos a par, dou-nos a minha paz, não olhei os nossos pecados, mas a fé da vossa igreja, e dai-nos a união e a paz, segundo a vossa vontade, forte, Senhor Deus, com o Pai, na unidade do Espírito Santo. Amém. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amém. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. We had the intention of having someone else help me, but we all forgot to bring another pyx, so I only had one, and this is for the wine, the blood of Christ, so therefore I'll be giving communion in the middle, and so the best is come all the front row, come here, and then return in the second, so I'll be the only one giving communion. Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
final, porque assim ficámos todos na mesma sala e fomos ao final uma família. It was a wonderful idea to wait until this memorial service to happen to then give the final blessing, because after all, we are all in this together, we are a family. During the homily, I should have mentioned that Borsos Milagrosos, the patron Blues American family, and we should follow his example of being good to everyone, even forgiving those who may not deserve our forgiveness, but to be another good Jesus in the life of one another. And also follow the example of Saint Isabel to be to practice charity and good deeds to one another, especially to those who need the most. And before the final bless, I'd like to thank José Silva and his choir, so that's the Terra from Five Winds Church. I would like to thank Joe and Teresa Machado who helped me set the altar and prepare. They were supposed to help me with communion, but unfortunately we didn't think of bringing other pigs, so I ended up doing it all, but they had the intention of doing it. And also thank you to Maria Jorge and Audrey Macias de Burman for this memorial rose ceremony, memorial service, and for the SPR SI prayer in memorial. Also, I'd like to thank Anais, our sound controller, who helped me with the microphone, the lectures, those who brought the bread and wine, those who did the collection. Thank the incoming president, Roxanne Aguilar, for inviting me last year to preside at this mass. Thank you, Roxanne, for your trust in me. You know, it's a risk nowadays to invite me for anything, because even myself, I never know what I'm going to say. Whatever comes up, comes up. Thank you for trusting me very much. And thank you all for being here. And we were supposed to have an invite, it didn't show up. But I managed to do it this way. I use online. If it was, I would have to share. So, for the love of Christ. Please stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The love of God by loving one another. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.